Hi, I'm Kirby Allison, and in today's video, I'm excited to tell you about a new series where we go through in detail really what I'm wearing each day and what went into its selection process. I'm Kirby Allison, and I love helping the well-dressed acquire and care for their wardrobes. Join me as we explore the world of quality, craftsmanship, and tradition. Every morning, whenever I'm getting ready, I really organize my wardrobe around a fundamental anchor piece. Either it's a jacket that I want to wear or a pair of trousers. Now today, because it's quite cold here in Dallas, it's a really cold late October morning, 40 degrees outside, I knew that I wanted to wear these navy flannel trousers. Now, of course, it's the first cold front really to sweep through Dallas, and so I was looking forward to finally getting back to my fall kind of winter seasonal selection of odd trousers. So today, really the first thing I selected this morning was the trousers, and that is what I built my wardrobe around. Now, whenever I'm getting dressed in the morning, again, I start with that fundamental anchor piece, and then I go to the other side of that. So if I'm choosing to start with a pair of trousers, then what I'll do is next go to the jacket that I want to wear. Now, these are a relatively dark navy pair of trousers. They're flannel, so they have a little bit of texture. And so I knew I needed a jacket that was going to have enough of a contrast to really kind of stand apart and not blend into the trousers. So this odd jacket, it's a Dorme fabric, 50% wool, 30% linen, and 20% silk. Really is a light enough blue to stand off and away from these trousers, and also has a slight enough difference in texture, again, to not blend in and to not clash with these flannel trousers. Since this particular jacket has this lovely brown window pane and also quite a bit of texture, I decided to go with a slightly more simplistic white shirt, really giving me a clean canvas that wasn't going to in any way distract from the jacket itself, and then to give me a lot of possibilities for the tie. Now, one of the fundamentals and one of the principles I keep in my mind whenever I'm getting dressed is that you have to be careful about combining too many different colors, textures, or patterns, right? So if you've got a jacket with a particularly strong pattern or texture, generally you want to stay pretty safe with one of the other two elements of tie or shirt. So if you're going to have a tie with a pattern on it like this one does, then you want to stay relatively simple with the shirt. Or alternatively, if I was wearing a striped shirt, then I would probably want to stick to a solid tie. But with this particular jacket, that could probably be tough. Today, I pulled out a navy pair of cashmere socks that again go perfectly with these trousers. It's a close match in terms of the color and also a very close match in terms of texture, because the cashmere socks really have that soft finish, just like a beautiful pair of flannel trousers. Since it's a darker ensemble, I went with a black pair of shoes. These are my bespoke George Cleverly Lazy Men. Again, very simple shoes. There's a lot of things that I could have done with the shoes, but these are just the ones I chose today. So at that point, I'm almost completely done with putting together the wardrobe, and you really end on what is the most fun part, which is choosing the tie and the pocket square. This is where you get to have a little bit of fun playing around. So the reason I chose this particular tie is because, again, this red really stands off well against the shirt, but then also ties to this brown kind of window pane. And this brown is an interesting brown. It's kind of an orangish, rusty brown. And then also trying to pick up that secondary color, the blue indigo of the Ancient Matter, really is brought out by the blue of the jacket. So two elements that I really liked and that led me to choose this particular tie. Now, I was a little bit less compelled by the pocket square, you know, but what I chose was a simple kind of Ancient Matter pocket square. You can see the indigo dye on the back. These are actually quite rare. There's not many people that do pocket squares out of Ancient Matter, which is a really old dye process where basically the raw silk is printed. All of the colors except for the blue are printed. And then this particular blue would be left undyed. And then the entire piece of silk is then dipped into an indigo bath. Now that's why you can always tell Ancient Matter by looking on the reverse side of the silk, because you see that indigo dye on there. It gives really interesting colors, has a nice kind of chalky hand. And so, you know, I chose this because, you know, honestly, I enjoy wearing Ancient Matter. The burgundy kind of works a little bit with the tie and then also with this particular window pane. So next, let's take a look at two other ties that I think could have worked well with this particular outfit. And so if I wanted to take this a little bit brighter, this tie right here, I think really would have worked beautifully. Almost just as well as this particular red Ancient Matter tie I'm wearing. It's a little bit brighter, would have certainly brightened up this outfit a bit. But again, this red and yellow, really both of those colors, really work well with this brown particular window pane. Now, I probably would have gone for a different pocket square because there's no colors that this particular pocket square really coordinates with this tie. This wool challis tie really offers a nice kind of soft texture that I think works very well here. So why don't I put this on and then we'll go find a pocket square that I think would work with this jacket, trousers, and shirt, and this particular beautiful sovereign grade tie. Okay, so I put this wool challis tie on here, and I have to say, I think I might enjoy this even better than the one I chose this morning. I guess that's the benefit of having a large selection of ties here at the office. But this is an absolutely beautiful tie. This texture really works well with this jacket. I mean, it's differentiated. It's a nice kind of contrast. It works with the flannel trousers. And the chestnut slash gold, again, really coordinates well with the particular window pane that we have here. Now, as we were discussing earlier, the final piece of the puzzle is that pocket square. And normally, it's oftentimes the last thing I select in the morning, maybe only second to the fragrance, which is normally the last thing I do. So the first pocket square, you know, worked. But again, you know, put this in here and it's just a little too much burgundy. I mean, it works okay. Doesn't work great. I mean, you could get away with this. Probably. But I think that instead, the better choice would be something that's really going to bring out the yellows kind of tone in the accent color in this tie. So I went into the warehouse and we found one of our printed silk pocket squares. This is a beautiful kind of light silk. And so when I fold this, what I'm going to do is really try to get as much of the edge as possible. So let's play around with this. Stuff it in there some more. That's okay. I mean, I could still play around with that a little bit. But again, this yellow is pulling out, that yellow here and that chestnut. And I think this really works well. So let's kind of take a look. Let me know what you think in the comments section below. Again, we're just kind of playing around, having a little bit of fun. Of course, if you're just visiting this YouTube channel for the first time, please hit that red subscribe button in the lower right-hand corner so that you can learn whenever we release new videos. Check out our extensive archive of shoe shine tutorials and other travel videos, like a lot of our London videos, our London update series that we just launched. And if you don't follow me on Instagram at Kirby Allison, I invite you to do so. It's the best way, really, to stay up to date about what's going on in this world. And if you haven't visited KirbyAllison.com, please do so. It's how we support this YouTube channel. And there you'll find the largest collection of luxury garment care accessories, luxury shoe care accessories, and other great clothing accessories like these sovereign grade neckties and pocket squares that we were playing around with today. I'm Kirby Allison, and I love to help the well-dressed acquire and care for their wardrobes while exploring the world of quality, craftsmanship, and tradition. Thanks for watching today.